Hello, my good friend Alexander asked me what kind of equipment I'm using to do these recordings and which programs am I using. If I could make a short video just about the equipment and the programs that I'm using to create these introductionary videos, and that is what I'm going to do today. First of all, the program that I'm recording in is called OBS Studio. And it's right now it's version 23, and it's free and open source video recording software. It's also it can also be used for live streaming, and I think this piece of software is just brilliant. It's incredible what they have accomplished. For instance, we have all our sources down here. We have an audio source, we have a video source, and then we have the screen capture, which is the screen itself. And the way that I have made the transparent background is by applying a filter to the video. And that is pretty easy. Just right click, choose filter, and then you can add something called a chroma key. You can press the plus button down here, and you can add the kind that is called a chroma key. You need to adjust the settings a little bit to get the right similarity and the right color. But most of the times, actually, the default green, that is a correct color, if you, especially if you buy a special blanket or the blanket that you can buy online that is for this purpose of streaming and recording. So actually I have a green blanket in my background right now. I'll just remove the similarity to one, and you can actually see that here there's a blanket. Of course, the less texture, what I call it, the less folds and the are in the blanket, the better. And of course, the more light you can place on the blanket, the better. And the similarity value that I found is suitable is for my purposes and my surroundings is 480. But that all these properties are something you need to tweak a bit to make the background disappear, but also to not to make and not to make holes in the things you actually want to show. You can see what happens if I turn up the similarity. I will disappear totally in the end. So I'll just place it again on 480. And you can, of course, you can choose your own color and custom color if you want to. If you have it, like say you have a blue screen, you can also choose the blue default color. Or if you have another kind color of, I mean blanket, if you have another color blanket, then you just choose custom blanket, custom color, and then you choose the color of the blanket that you actually have. You can also choose a pick screen color, and then you can actually choose the color from the screen itself to get an accurate value. But in my case, actually, the default green color, that's the one that suits the best. Another thing that is this is the audio, and I have a Yeti blue microphone, and here I can choose the volume, and I can turn it all the way down, so now you can almost not hear me, and I can turn it all the way down up, so now there's the full volume. And that's actually what it is. What is needed. There's another setting I've set is on the settings. Then you can actually choose the bit rate. And if I go to output and then choose recording, then I have set the bit rate to 3,000, and the default value is 2,500. That was a little bit too. The value was a little bit too little for the value was too small for my purposes. And when I show text on the screen, it will actually seem blurry. So if you have blurry text or something that's blurry, then increase the bit rate a little bit. So, but of course, the higher the bit rate, the larger the file will end up, the MP4 file. And then I chose the zero latency, and I said that I have a really fast CPU, but play with all these settings and see what happens. The audio, that is 44.1 kilohertz. Yeah, that's it. And then when I'm done creating a video, let's say that I want to add some special effects or something. Then there's a program called OpenShot, and this is also an amazing piece of software. It's right now it's 2.4. And this this software actually allows you to drag in something called tracks, and each track, and it could be different movies that you want to mix, or maybe you want to make a special effects when going from one movie to another movie. You can also place the audio in its own track if you want to synchronize the audio a little bit better. Yeah, and you can cut stuff away, and let's say that you actually have some noise in your video, then first you can actually go to VLC, and then you can actually cut out the audio there, and then you can import it into OpenShot, and then you can remove the noise, simply, and then you can remove the noise, and then you can import into OpenShot after removing the noise, and then you can actually synchronize the new soundtrack with the old video track. This is all very cool, but play with it, and there's plenty of tutorials to see how these pieces of software work. But just play with the pieces with the software here. Then most of it is just very intuitive. The equipment I'm using is the Logitech C922 Pro camera. I think this is really good for the very good value for the money. And then it has a capability of recording in full high definition, 1080p or 720p at 60 frames per second. But usually when recording stuff, you just need like 25 to 30 frames per second. That's enough. And also the resolution, actually, when I'm recording stuff like this, then I'm only using a small part of the screen for my own face, and that means that you don't need very high resolution to do this. Of course, if you want to record something in full screen where the video is in full screen, then of course it's nice to have the capability of having a high resolution. Another piece of hardware I'm using is the Blue Yeti microphone. And again, I think it's very good. There's plenty of microphones and also plenty of webcams to choose from. But I really like this Yeti Blue microphone here. It does what it should. And actually, you don't need to speak directly into the microphone. You actually need to speak it actually captures the sound from the side. So from the sides. I'll just show it here. You see here, I have it here standing here on the table. So if you see any streamers talking into it like this, then it's because they haven't read the manual. That section says that the sound goes in from the sides instead. So it's actually a stereo microphone that takes sounds in from the sides. That's actually it. Alexander, I hope you got all your answers, all your questions answered, or else just place them in the comments and I will reply to them later. And yes, that's it. I might make a movie later on regarding the software, how to use them in depth. But I think there are some very, very, very good tutorials out there to view. Thank you very much. Hope to see you again another time.